Welcome, okay. Wellness Warriors, yeah. To another Q&A with Professor Fay. Mm-hmm. That's me. Mm-hmm. welcome. We always love doing these. I'm going to put my thinking cap on, which is In Tune Focus Blend. So are you ready to go, Mr.
Epps? I am basically ready to go. Yeah. Yeah, I definitely just want to check every feed, and so far so good. Everything's looking good.
You know, and thank you for the questions, and keep sending those questions to us. Absolutely. And we look forward to helping you on your wellness lifestyle journey. Mm-hmm. And that's, you know, really what this is. Joel and I started a long time ago.
Yes.
A long time ago. I was, 17 when I started exploring all this. Mm-hmm. And shortly after we met, we really started changing our diet. Mm-hmm. And, mm-hmm. Our mental and emotional health, I mean, spiritual health as well, we really started diving into this. And one of the things that I really started to dive into that I want to share with you and help point out some of the areas where maybe our current healthcare system is a little confused about. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that's the idea of
Can I ask the question? Yes.
Ahead.
So, what is preventative healthcare?
Yeah. Good question. The question for today is, what is preventative healthcare? And on one hand, you know, when we talk about disease prevention, and if you look up the definition of disease prevention, it's really pretty cool. It's taking positive actions now to prevent becoming sick later.
Yeah.
Right? And so you would think in prevention programs, they would really be focusing on behaviors and lifestyle choices that prevent becoming sick later. But we again have to look kind of at where our healthcare system is at and kind of how it's evolved in a way. And for the longest time, what had happened was we got more and more into the disease model. The disease model of care. And most doctors in medical school are trained on pathology. They look for illness. They look for sickness. And it doesn't mean that they want to be bad doctors. It doesn't mean that they want to harm you. It just often means that what happens is they come out with this bias of looking for what's wrong. And then finding a treatment. And what happened over time is we got into there's three levels of preventative care. And the lowest and the most costly form is what's called tertiary prevention. And that's where the healthcare system ended up for a long time. And basically the attitude was, hey, if you're not sick, if you're not broken, you're fine. Come back when there's something obviously wrong. And that kind of gets back to, if you remember what we talked about last week, definition of health, if you don't have a full-blown illness, you're fine, you're healthy. And so tertiary care was that idea, like until there was really something wrong, like you have a heart attack, okay, now we can deal with that. Or you have a stroke, now we can deal with that. Or full-blown cancer, okay, now we treat that. And the problem with that form of care, one, it's very costly, most expensive form, right? Open heart surgery is very expensive, and rehabilitation takes a long time. So it's costly that way as well. And in fact, the single largest reason for bankruptcy in the US, in fact, 2/3 of all bankruptcies have to do with healthcare costs. Yes, because that's a whole nother thing, but just know, right, very costly, long time to recuperate. And so what was happening, not only was it causing individuals to become bankrupt, it was causing hospitals and health insurance companies, especially health insurance companies, to lose too much money. And so they started to focus on the next level up, which is called secondary prevention. And this is early detection, or detection before illness is too bad. So kind of early detection and intervention before a person gets seriously ill.
So there's tertiary, right, which is treating after the person's sick.
Yes.
And then there's what you just call secondary, which is trying to do testing to check to see if there's the signs of
exactly the beginnings of disease state.
Okay.
So this is really where our current healthcare system is. It's where we say, come in for regular checkups. So we can test your blood and see if there's a problem, or get your blood pressure monitored. And if your blood pressure is high, let's put you on a medication to lower it, because we know high blood pressure can lead to stroke or heart disease. Or let's measure your cholesterol. And if your cholesterol is high, let's give you medication to lower it, because it can lead to atherosclerosis and cardiovascular disease.
Okay.
Right? Even now, fortunately, starting to recognize stress. Oh, you have a high stress. Well, let's put you on some medication, anti-anxiety medication, to help reduce your anxiety. Now, again, this is not true prevention. Where the individual that's having these symptoms is still sick at this point.
Right.
So true prevention happens at the what we call primary prevention. And this is really about developing those habits, the eating, the lifestyle choices, the exercise, the stress management, developing those habits that not only prevent any signs of disease, but actually support your system in functioning at its best. And so, you know, some examples, obviously education would be one. What else?
Well, you exercise.
Exercise, right? Joining a gym, things like that. Now, what would you say would be the biggest challenge or roadblock to primary prevention? Like, it makes sense that is the best form of prevention. Yet so much of these charities that are out there, like Susan B. Komen, right, for cancer, it's about detection. All that money goes into treatment of cancer. It is not focused on prevention, right? And many other programs that are out there, charities.
You know, it's called prevention.
Yes.
It's really detection.
Yes.
Okay.
It's called prevention, but when you look at it, it's early detection and treatment of cancer.
Okay.
Right? If you're treating it, it means you already have it.
Right.
If it's about finding a cure, it means you're already sick. And that's what all these charities are about. So how can we shift? And what is probably the biggest challenge to really adopting this primary prevention model? Doing the things before there's even any symptoms to keep it that way, to keep you feeling good. What's the biggest deterrent?
I mean, the biggest reason why people
don't
do it?
Yeah.
Probably because they're not motivated.
Yeah, their lack of motivation is one. Yeah. Like, I feel fine.
Why should I change anything?
Yeah. Or the environment. We have a pretty unhealthy environment, right? Toxic stuff all over. Or maybe feeling lack of time or lack of money, lack of ability, lack of education, right? So there are some real deterrents, but this is where learning how to form new habits becomes really important. I think most people know what to do, but how to change behaviors is probably the biggest deterrent. Because when you're young, hey, I feel good, it tastes good, why, you know, why do I have to do it? And you develop these habits then over time, and it catches up with you. So the best place is with our young, before they develop these habits that lead to a problem. But the second best place is now, no matter where you're at. So that'll be another topic for Q&A with Professor Fay. How to change behaviors. Yes. So thank you. Make sure you, if you want to continue learning more about a healthy lifestyle, join our Facebook group, Learning About Essential Oils, starting on this coming Monday. We will, what date is that?
The 17th.
Okay. We will be having a week-long little class on
deep dive into love and relationships.
Yes. So make sure you hop over to Learning About Essential Oils. Join so you can be part of that class and join us next Tuesday, same time, same place.
One last thing, we just want to make sure that everybody knows that the way this works is to type in the comment section a question, and then we will choose one of the questions for next week, and we will also put your name into a drawing, and you can win a special gift from us for participating and asking questions and being part of this. We really appreciate everybody. We want to thank you all for being here. And stay tuned next week. It's going to get heavy. It's going to get deep. And no holds barred here.
Nope, not at all. And now I challenge you over the next week, this week, to start becoming aware of your habits. And is it helping to support wellness? Or is it taking away from wellness? More to come. Thanks, you guys. Love you. And as always,
peace out.
Peace out.